गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. टुडे वी शैल बी कंटिन्यूइंग द सेम चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर 3, रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ ट्रांजैक्शन एंड प्रिपरेशन ऑफ ट्रायल बैलेंस, इन विच वी आर डूइंग सेक्शन 3 कैश बुक एंड वी वर डूइंग द ट्रिपल कॉलम कैश बुक. ओके, सो वी विल कंटिन्यू दिस ट्रिपल कॉलम कैश बुक ओनली एंड वी विल गेट टू नो मच अबाउट द ट्रेड डिस्काउंट, ओके, एंड कैश डिस्काउंट. ओके, so related to this two only we will be going to do the triple column cash book today. As trade discount, you know, it will be not recorded in the books. We will do the calculation for this discount, but we will not record it into the book. Okay, it should be not recorded in the book, but cash discount should be recorded in the book. Okay, we have to record, give the entry for book entry. It should be necessary for this cash discount. Okay, so trade discount not comes into the book entry, but cash discount comes into the book entry. So related to this, we'll do now a practical sum. So come to the question, student.
Here it is saying, from the following particulars, prepare a suitable cash book for the month of March 2016 and bring down the balances. Okay, so here are the transaction that has been started on March 1. It is saying, sold goods to Amit rupees 4000 and less 10% trade discount. So it has also given the 10% trade discounts. Okay, and receive check next day. We have received a check. We have received the amount into the bank, okay, through the medium of check, and after allowing 5% of cash discount. So at the time of payment, we have also given the cash discount also. Okay, so for this we have to do a working note also, that we will do now. Okay, then come to the next transaction that is done on 13th March. Purchase goods from Shashi rupees 2000, in that he got less 5% discount. So we have received, okay, we have received, because we are purchasing the goods, so we have to pay the amount for purchasing the goods. So we have received a 5% trade discount, and at the time of payment we are paying through check, so we have to record at the bank column the amount. Okay, and at the time of payment we have also got 2% cash discount. So for this transaction also we have to do some working note. Okay, so come to the working note, students.
So the first working note we have to do for the transaction that has been done on 6th March, that is for sold goods to Amit rupees 4000, and it got the trade discount on that 4000, that is 10%. So we have to calculate the trade discount first. Okay, so it is saying the trade discount on is 10% of 4000. Okay, so that means we will get 400 trade discount. Okay, so after we multiply, so after we subtract 400 from this 4000, we will get the net amount of Amit. Okay, so the net amount will be 4000 minus 400, that is 3600. Then at the time of payment he also got some cash discount. Okay, that is for 5%, so that we also have to find out here, that is cash discount is 5%. Okay, so 5% on which amount? On the net amount that we have got. Okay, so 5% of 3600, so we will get here rupees 180. Okay, so this is our cash discount that we have to record in the book. We don't have to record this 400, that the trade discount we don't have to record. We have to record the 180. Okay, then what is the final amount of check will be paid? Okay, so amount of check that should be paid after deducting the trade discount and cash discount. Okay, amount of check will be 3600 minus 180 cash discount, we will get rupees 3420. Okay, so this amount we have to record in the book at the debit side in the Amit account. Okay, now come to the next working note. Now the next working note for the transaction on 13th March that has been done. Okay, purchase goods from Shashi rupees 2000 and there was trade discount of 5%. Okay, so we have to find the trade discount of 5% of what amount? 5% of 2000. Okay, so 5% of 2000 we will get 100. Okay, so after subtracting this 100 from this 2000 we will get the net amount that will be 1900 rupees. Okay, then again we have found received some cash discount also. Okay, so that cash discount was 2%. 2% on this net amount we have to find out. So 2% of 1900. Okay, so the amount that we will get is rupees 38. So this is our cash discount that we have to record in the book. Okay, and the amount of check will be 1900 minus 38. Okay, we will get rupees 1862. Okay, so this amount we have to pay to Shashi for the goods purchased. Okay, so this is the format for a triple column cash book. As you know, this is the three columns: cash, bank and discount allowed. Okay, so come to the question. The first transaction is done on 1st March in the year 2016. So we will write here 2016 and then we will write here March 1. Okay, and the transaction is overdraft balance at bank. That means the company has some overdraft, has some loan. Okay, so that we have to record at the credit side because it has the loan. So we will write the year and March 1 and we will write as by balance BD. Okay, so that is the balance that the company had to pay, that the company had the overdraft for 2000. Okay, so we will record here 2000 at bank column because it has the overdraft in at bank. Okay, and then it is saying cash in hand, so we will write here to balance BD. And we have the cash in the company, that is cash in hand 700. Okay, then it is next transaction is on 4th March. Okay, it is saying received from sales and paid into bank. Okay, so that means we have to record at the debit side because it is a sales account. So to sales account we are getting the money by selling the goods. Okay, and the amount is 8250 that we have to record at the bank column because we are receiving the money through check. Okay, and we have to write the narration also here being cash sales. Okay, paid into bank. Okay, now come to the next transaction that has been done on 6th March. It is saying sold goods to Amit rupees 4000. That we have done the working notes also. We have done the 10% trade discount and the 5% cash discount. After all the calculation, we have got 3420 that we have to record at the debit side. Okay, so just write the date 6 and then we have to record like to Amit account. Okay, you can see the note 1 that we have done. Okay, and we have to record at the bank column because we are getting the check through check. That's why we have to record at the bank column. We are getting the cash into the bank and we have the cash discount of 180. We will not record the trade discount. We will record the cash discount 5% because trade discount is not recorded in the book. Okay, that's why. Now come to the next entry. It is done on 9th March, that is purchased furniture and paid by check. So purchased furniture, that we have to record at the credit side. We will write 9 because the transaction has been done on 9th March. Purchased furniture, so we will record buy furniture account, okay? Buy furniture account, and the amount is rupees 1000 because the amount is paid by check. So that is why on the bank column we have to record and we have to write the narration for this being furniture purchased by check. Okay, then come to the next entry. We have not written the narration here for Amitam account. We have to write the narration here also. Being check received from Amit and allowed discount to him also. Okay, that allowed, we have discount, that we have to write here. Allowed discount. Okay. Then come to the next entry that has been done on 19th March. Okay, purchase goods, that means we have to record at the credit side. Okay, so on 13th March, what has been done? Purchase goods from Sashi rupees 2000 less 5% rate. All the working notes that we have done, okay, for Sashi, we have got after all the calculation, after deducting the trade discount and cash discount, we have got 1862 that we have to record here by writing by purchase account, okay. You can follow the note 2, okay, that we have done the working note 2, that you can follow for this entry. And we have to record at the bank column because we are paying it through check. So we have to record here 1862, and the discount, the cash discount only we will record here. The trade discount is not recorded in the book. So the 38 rupees is the cash discount, okay. Then we have to write the narration for this, okay. Being paid by check, okay. And discount received, okay. Now come to the next transaction that has been done on 17th March, received from Tarun on account, okay. So it is receiving, so that means coming to the business. So we will write here 17th and we will record to Tarun account, okay. And the amount is 650 that we have to record in the cash column because Tarun is giving cash, okay. Now write the narration. Being amount received on account, okay. Now come to the next entry that has been done on 20th March, drew from cash and paid salary, okay, that is for 300, okay. So drew from cash, that means he has paid the salary. We are paying the salary by through cash, so we have to record at the credit side, okay. The date is 20 and we have to record by salary account, okay. And the amount we have to record in the cash column because through cash we are paying the salary, that is 300, okay. And write the narration. Being salary paid, okay. Now come to the next transaction. It is saying that on 24th March, paid Bhaskar for rupees 400 in full satisfaction, okay. So that means he has to pay the 400, but he had paid 380, okay. So that means 20 rupees is the discount, okay, that we have received. So we have to record here because we are paying to Bhaskar on 24th. So we have to write by Bhaskar account, okay. and then the amount is 380. He has to pay the 400, but we have received 20 rupees discount and we have paid to Bhaskar 380, okay, not 400. So that is the discount we have received, 20 rupees, okay. And then write the narration being cash paid and discount received, okay. Then come to the next transaction that has been done on 27th March, received from Prabodh for rupees 500 in full satisfaction, that is 450. Okay, so we have received, though we have to record on the debit side by writing 27th here on the date column, and we have received from Pramodh. So to Prabodh account, and we have not given the 500 full, we have given 450. Okay, so we have to record at the cash column 450, and then we have to record 50 rupees discount allowed, okay, because we have not paid 500, we have got 450. He has given us 450, so we have allowed the discount of rupees 50 that we have to record in the discount column. Got it? So write the narration for this being cash received and discount allowed, okay. Then come to the next transaction on 29th March, okay. 29 March, so it is saying paid all cash except rupees 400 into bank, okay. So we have to do a calculation for this. It is saying the all the cash except 400 we have to put it to the bank account, okay. So that means we have to calculate. So come to the working note. So as it is saying, we have to deposit all the amount into the bank except rupees 400. So we have to find out first the total cash, okay, that we have in hand, okay. So the debit side, okay, so the debit side cash amounts we have to add first, that we have 700, okay. Then we have 650, okay, and 450. This is the debit amount, okay. Then from this we have to subtract the credit cash column amount, okay. Then only we will get to know our total cash that is there, okay. So the credit amount is 300 and 380. These two amounts are there in the credit cash column, okay. So after doing the calculation, we will get rupees 1120. This is our total cash, okay. The cash in hand on 29th March before depositing into the bank. So before depositing we have this amount, okay. So now we have to deposit, but we have to keep 400, okay. Except 400 we have to do the rest. So the balance that we have to deposit in the bank, we have to find out that, okay. So rupees 1120 is our total cash. From that we have to subtract that 400, so we will get the balance of rupees 720. This amount will be deposited into the bank. So this is the amount that we have to record in the book, okay. So after the working note, now we have know what we have to put into the bank. So we have to write here by bank account, okay. You can see the note 3 that we have done just now, okay, and the amount is 720 that we have to write in the cash column, because we have depositing the cash into the bank. So the cash is going out, so we are recording on the credit side, but it will come into the company only, so we have to do the contra entry for this. So we will write C here, and opposite side we have to write the entry by writing to cash account, because we are depositing the cash into the bank, so cash is coming into the business. Here we have to record the same amount in the bank column. Got it? Okay, now it is done. We don't have to put the narration, we just have to put the C initial in the ledger folio column. Now come to the last transaction that has been done on 31st March. It is saying bank allowed interest on deposit. Okay, so we have got interest from the bank, so the amount is coming into the business, so we have to record in the debit side by writing to interest account. Okay, the amount is 25. Okay, that we have to write in the bank column because we are getting the interest on bank account. Okay, and write the narration being interest on deposit received. Okay, now we have to do the total. So if you add here, you will get 1800. Here you will get 12,415, and here you will get 230. Okay, now we have to write the same amount total here. 1800, 12,415, and here the discount column is 58. Okay, now the deficit amount that we have to record here by writing 31st by balance CD. Okay, so the deficit amount we will get, we know here will be 400, because only 400 we have to kept for cash, and all the other amount we have deposited into bank, so obviously here we will get 400, and in the bank column we will get the deficit amount, that is 7,553. So this left out carried down amount we have to brought down for the next month here, for April 1. Okay, we will write to balance BT, that is brought down, and we will write the 400 and 7,553 for the bank column. Okay, so that's all for today's class. I have given you two sums for your homework. Please do it and submit it in the given mail ID. Okay, thank you all of you.